attention this morning is for Jean McGuigan by her family. And as usual, we ask you to mute the sounds on your cell phones and any other electronic equipment.
I Please stand. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
And welcome. We sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May our Lord be with all of you.
Amen.
And we go before the Lord this morning, acknowledging our sins, so we can celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to all sinners. Christ, have mercy.
And
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who by the glorification of Christ and the light of the Holy Spirit have unlocked for us the gates of eternity, grant, we pray, that partaking of such a great gift, our devotion may grow deeper and our faith be strengthened. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. King Agrippa and Bernice arrived in Caesarea on a visit to Festus. Since they spent several days there, Festus referred Paul's case to the king, saying, "There is a man here left in custody by Felix. When I was in Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and demanded his condemnation. I answered him that it was not Roman practice to hand over an accused person before he has faced his accusers. And they had so when they came together here, I made no delay. The next day, I took my seat on the tribunal and ordered the man to be brought in. His accusers stood around him, but did not charge him with any of the crimes I suspected. Instead, they had some issues with him about their own religion and about a certain Jesus who had died. But who Paul claimed was alive. Since I was at a loss how to investigate this controversy, I asked if he were willing to go to Jerusalem and there stand trial on these charges. And when Paul appealed that he had been held in custody for the emperor's decision, I ordered him held until I could send him to Caesar." The word of the Lord. The Lord has established his throne in heaven. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing his kindness towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, So far has he put our transgressions from us. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, you mighty in strength, who do his bidding.
And the Lord be with you. A reading of the Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. After Jesus had revealed himself to his disciples and eaten breakfast with them, he said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? And Simon Peter answered him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my lambs. He said to him again, to Simon Peter a second time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? And Simon answered him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Tend my sheep. And he said to him a third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? And Peter was distressed that he had said to him a third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. And Jesus said to him, Feed my sheep. Amen, amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourselves and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. And he said this, signifying of what kind of death would glorify God. And when he was as said this, he said to him, Follow me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Within that gospel story that we just heard, we hear a dialogue between Simon Peter and also our Lord, and the questions that were there, Do you love me? And each time there was a response. And we know that Peter loved him. And so, you know, at the end of that, we get a little bit of discourse going on and saying, okay, this is what needs to be done. Take care of the young, take care of the old. You all take care of the young. The young take care of the old. And so, you know, what is happening there? We stop and think about that during this time of the pandemic that we're in, is how we're taking care of each other. And that's part of the mission that has really been entrusted to us, is taking care of each other. We've heard within the other passages from the whole time during the Easter season of how the early Christian communities did that. And they encouraged the Christian communities to do that at the present moment. And the pandemic is one of the reasons, is one way that we can do it. Looking after the needs of those that have been entrusted to us. Okay, how do we do that? Often enough is the question. Well, keeping our social distance was helpful. And also wearing the mask where it's necessary. And also, we'll be looking after our brothers and sisters who are going hungry, who are unemployed. Maybe those who are suffering in some way that we don't know about. And trying to assist them in some way and take care of them, because they have been entrusted to us as well, along with our family and with our friends. Everybody is entrusted to us because of the call that we have received, okay, the time of baptism to the present moment. So, you know, during this time period, we're going to say, yes, it's going to be tough. It's going to be rough. But we're there for each other and working with each other is trying to overcome some of the difficulties that we are experiencing and seeing it in a different light, maybe, but we're also practicing that other command of loving God and neighbor. Because our Lord kept asking Peter, "Do you love me?" And he turned around and said, "Yes, I do." And the Lord says the same thing to us, "Do you love me?" And we can turn around and say, "Yes, we do." And then how we go about doing that shows that our love for the Lord is going to be exemplified in the love that we show towards our neighbor. And so, like I said, during this pandemic, that's one way that we can go work with it and show our love to those that are in need around us, that may come to us in any way, shape, or form to assist them and make them feel comfortable and give them a sense of respect and dignity as well. And so we pray for God's people today. We are praying for the church and all its people, that we continue to be a beacon of light of hope for everyone. We pray to the Lord. Glory to hear our prayer. For all those who are traveling, that they reach their destination safely and unharmed, we pray to the Lord. For all those that have been entrusted to us, that we take good care of them, we pray to the Lord. For all those that are sick, that we take care of them too, and may they feel our prayers for them, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who have died, that they be sharing God's eternal presence, a place prepared for them in His kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And we continue to pray for ourselves, for the gift of patience and understanding and mercy and kindness, that those will be evident and prominent within our lives this day, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And so, Lord Jesus, we do stop. We gather all the prayers and offer them to you. We ask that you continue to give us what we need for the journey. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours is acceptable to God the Father, the Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His church. Look mercifully, O Lord, we pray, upon the sacrificial gifts of your people, and that they may become acceptable to you. Let the coming of the Holy Spirit cleanse our consciousness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all of his disciples, and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that they might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, come with paschal joy, every land, every people, exalt in your praise. We join them and form one voice as we acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory, O Son, in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered all into his passion, he took bread and given thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, and all of you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks, you count us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Only we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, and the clergy. And remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may learn to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And so we pray in the words of Jesus as taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace, Lord, be with you always.
Amen.
And let us offer a sign of peace. Peace, everybody. Blessed is called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us make
our spiritual communion together. By Jesus, I believe that you are really present in this most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you to come into my soul. Though I cannot receive you now sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Let us pray. O God, by whose mysteries we are cleansed and nourished, grant we pray that this banquet which we give you and you have given us may bring everlasting life through Christ our Lord. Amen. And May the Holy Church rejoice in glorifying this priest as your own heart, who gave himself totally to your love. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless all of us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.